another fun technique to do is something called direct to stamp. And really, it's quite straightforward when you list or when you think about what the technique is called. You're going to take your marker and you're going to color it directly on your stamp. Now, you do want to be careful when you are doing this technique. You don't want to be aggressive with your markers because you can start to break down your markers. The tips of them, they last really nicely as long as you're taking care of them and being careful with them. If you're aggressive with this technique, because there are some rough edges on the stamp where you've got the detail, you can start to wreck your markers. I did a class once and some of the ladies were not very careful with this technique and they ended up some of the markers were completely broken up by the end of the class. And what I mean by that is, let me find it. So when you first get the markers, they're nice and pointed like this. Once they've broken down, oh, this one's not too bad actually. I thought this one was the worst one. Once they've broken down, they get really feathery. You don't have a point at the end of it. And basically you have the marker starts to dry out, and if you want to get a nice pointed tip, the only option is to use the pointed side or the fine tip of your marker. So you want to be careful. These markers, you can't re-ink them and you can't replace the tips of them. So once they dry out, you do have to throw them away and replace them. So it's always nice to make our tools last as long as possible. So I'm going to add a little bit of the dark green in certain areas. Some stamps are easier to see the detail than others, and this particular technique works better on stamps that are a little bit more solid than open. Like, you'll notice this flower is completely solid, whereas this one was just an outline. So you definitely want to choose stamps that have more solidness to them. Next thing you're going to do, because this ink has dried while we've been coloring, is you're going to huff on it, which kind of means blowing on it with hot air, just like you would if you were to clean some glasses. You're going to huff on it, that's going to re-moisten the ink, and then you're going to stamp with it. So you have to be kind of careful with it. So let's go. And I do it a couple times just because the image is fairly big. And once again, I'm holding steady with one hand and I'm using my other hand to press down. And there we go. We've got a nice, beautiful image of that stamp. Now from there, because this takes literally no time to dry, from there I would almost right away go and glue it to my mat and then glue it to the front of the card. I'm not going to do that for every card with this class because they're all done exactly the same way as the first card. But there you go. And now I'm going to show you that exact same method, just a little bit different way to give a faux watercolor look with this stamp. We'll see you in the next video.